Some people mentioned to me that they prefer not to shoot in RAW because they think that the editing process can be too long, too complicated, and overall very overwhelming. Of course, I strongly disagree with this, and I'm making this video to show you how simple and how quick the editing process can be. Welcome to my channel. Here I talk about photography and I make videos just like this one where I share some editing tips. So if you're here for the first time, it might be a good idea to subscribe. I don't know if you can hear, but right outside my studio they're making a new fence or something. Anyways, there is a lot of noise. I hope this is not disturbing. But anyways, I thought that in order to make sure that all the information I'm going to share about editing pictures in Lightroom can be digested and easily understood also by people with less Lightroom experience, I'm going to make a mini series of 3 videos that will help you to edit your landscape photography images in less than 5 minutes. And today's video is dedicated to the 5 adjustments that I make to every single image that I import into my Lightroom catalog. I might do a separate video dedicated to how import and organize your images in Lightroom. And actually, if you're interested in seeing a video about that, just let me know in the comments. But for now, instead, I am going to show you which are the 5 adjustments that I make to every single photo I import, and that will actually prepare my RAW file to be edited in Lightroom. Let's dive in. So here we are in Lightroom, and this is a long exposure. It's actually 70 seconds, f8, 20 millimeters. It's taken New Zealand, and this is Milford Sound, iconic, beautiful place. It's a little before sunset. And anyways, let's see which are these 5 necessary adjustments that I make to every single photo. So let's open the develop module. And as a first thing, I will open the lens corrections panel. And I will make sure to set the remove chromatic aberration on. So toggle on the remove chromatic aberration. This adjustment will remove the color fringing, which is an optical problem of the lens, which, when it happens, will create some funky color edges in your images. Often it's purple. Anyways, set this on and your image will be much cleaner. In the same panel, you want to make sure to enable the profile correction, and you immediately see how the image changed. Basically, the profile correction will get rid of any distortion or vignetting that your lens are causing. So as you can see, with 2 quick clicks, you have already a better image. And although this is very quick, I actually have these 2 adjustments set on as I import my images in the catalog. So basically, these will happen automatically. Okay, adjustment number 3, leveling, the alignment of my image. There are very few things that annoys me more than an image not completely leveled. So in order to double check or fix the leveling of your image, you want to open this crop and straighten panel up here. And once you're in, you can immediately click on auto. And as you can see, in this case, with the minus 0.08, there was a very, very little leveling to do. But sometimes the software gets confused and you might need to do this manually. In order to do so, you click on the straighten tool right here, and you will select a point on your horizon and then drag a line right into the horizon. And in this way, you are telling to the software what has to be straight. Click done and move on. Adjustment number 4, photo ratio. And now we're going to talk of an adjustment which is going to be the first one that will involve some creativity. My camera sensor is a 3x2, so every single image will come out with a 3x2 ratio, of course. But not necessarily this is the best ratio for every single composition I take. And especially if I want to export my images to Instagram or YouTube, clearly the best ratio for those media is 4x5 for Instagram, 16x9 for YouTube, and also sometimes my composition will just look better with a different photo ratio. In this case, for instance, I'm going to use this image for YouTube, and also because there's not much going on the very top, the very bottom as well, I will go with a 16x9, and also I might need to crop a little bit the left side because I had some branches that I didn't want to see. And this is done. Quick. Fifth and last adjustments that I make to every single photo is the spot removal. We are landscape photographers and we operate in the elements. For some reason, if there is a lot of wind, if there's dust, if there's sand, I feel the urge to switch lens. And the result is that in my images, often I will get some dust spots because the dust will deposit on my sensor. I try to keep it clean, I clean it myself, but often it's not enough. And especially in long exposure images, if there is a little piece of sand or a little dust in your sensor, it will show for sure in your photo. Luckily, in Lightroom it's very easy to get rid of these dust spots, and I will show you how. As you can see, this first circle up here is the spot removal. I usually set it on heel. I keep the feather at 100 and the opacity at 100. And I will click on the visualize spots here in the bottom left. And this tool will help me to identify where and if there are dust spots in my image. You will see these white elements. In this case, these are the pebbles under the water. But if you want to make sure, I actually toggle on and off the visualize spots. And eventually I click on the space bar so that I can zoom in, and then keeping the space bar clicked, I can actually drag the image and make sure that the visualized spots is actually identifying real dust spots and not elements of the photo. Like in this case, these elements up here are actually part of the photo and I don't need to get rid of it. It's pretty incredible, but this image is pretty clean. But let's pretend that this was a dust spot. You just click on it and as you can see, it's not there anymore. Click Z to see the full image, and that's it, it's done. Clearly, it takes more time to explain these adjustments than actually make them. For some of you, these might have been really basic. Nevertheless, make sure to prepare your RAW files with these adjustments every time before you start the real edit. Hope this was clear and useful to most of you. Hopefully, I'm starting to convince more people to shoot in RAW and edit their photos in Lightroom. Next week, we're going to see how to work on the basic panel, understanding every single slider, and trying to edit one image in less than 5 minutes. Now, if you want to give back, I don't ask for a lot, but you could like this video, share it with your friends, leave me a comment, and of course, subscribe in the remote case you didn't yet. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.